Hey kids, welcome to week two of our Bible study over how God restores us through prayer. Every Sunday at 6 p.m., we will be posting a video Bible lesson. You'll be able to find it here on the church Facebook page and on the Parent Info Facebook page. If you're unsure of what that is, simply search MZBC Youth and Children Info on Facebook. Be sure to print off the activity sheet below in the comments and use it to follow along the Bible story. And use the journal page to write down your thoughts during the lesson. So go ahead, grab your Bible, print off your journal page, and enjoy this worship music about how we should always praise God and give Him thanks. Asked you a question last week. Why do we pray? Here's a reminder of what 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16 through 18 says. It says, "Rejoice always, pray constantly, give thanks in everything, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus." Just like today's song said. Last week we learned about Daniel chapter 3, when Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego refused to bow down to a statue, because they knew the one true God. They prayed to God because they trusted God, and they knew that God heard them. I have a question for you. Have you ever had a really strange dream before? I remember a dream that I had where I was skydiving once, and when I pulled the parachute, an octopus came out, and I floated down while holding his tentacles. How weird is that? And today, we will look at Daniel chapter 4 and learn about the time that King Nebuchadnezzar, yes, the same one from Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, had a crazy dream that he didn't fully understand. Let's watch this video and learn about that weird dream and how God used that dream to bring glory to Himself.
Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, shared a message to tell everyone who would listen about the wonderful things God had done for him. One night, Nebuchadnezzar had a frightening dream. He called for all the wise men in Babylon to explain what the dream meant, but they did not understand the dream. Finally, Nebuchadnezzar told Daniel about the dream. I saw a big, strong tree. Its top was in the sky, and everyone could see it. The tree had beautiful leaves and fruit, and animals lived in and around the tree. An angel came down from heaven and said, "Cut down the tree. Take off its leaves and fruit. Let the animals hurry away." The angel said only the stump and roots would be left in the ground. Then the angel said, "The tree's mind would change from a human's mind into an animal's mind." He said this would happen so the people would know God is ruler over human kingdoms. The dream frightened Daniel too, and he told King Nebuchadnezzar what it meant. "The tree is you," Daniel explained. "You are great and strong, and your greatness reaches the sky." Then Daniel said, "Like the tree was cut down, you will be driven away from people. Instead, you will live with wild animals and eat grass. Like the stump was left in the ground, your kingdom will not be completely destroyed. It will be restored when you acknowledge that God rules over everything." A year later, the king's dream came true. He walked on the roof of his palace and said, "Babylon is great. I built this kingdom with my power and for my glory." Suddenly, the king heard a voice from heaven. "King Nebuchadnezzar, you will be driven away from people. You will live with wild animals and eat grass until you acknowledge that God rules over everything." Nebuchadnezzar was driven away from people. He ate grass like cattle. His hair grew like eagle's feathers, and his nails grew like bird's claws. After some time, Nebuchadnezzar looked up to heaven and praised God. He acknowledged that God rules everything. His kingdom was restored to him, and Nebuchadnezzar gave glory to God.
At the beginning of Daniel 4, King Nebuchadnezzar proclaimed God's glory. Look what it says here in Daniel chapter 4, verse 3. He says, "How great are his miracles, and how mighty his wonders. His kingdom is an eternal kingdom, and his dominion is from generation to generation." The king said these awesome things about the one true God. But shortly after, in Daniel chapter 4, verse 30, he starts bragging about all the things he's done in his own life. He even says that he built Babylon to show off his own majestic glory. Because of this, God had to punish the king to get his attention and to urge him to turn away from his sin. Remember, kids, in James chapter 4, verse 16, we are told that all boasting is evil. Pride steals God's glory. God humbled King Nebuchadnezzar so he could see that God alone deserves the glory. Jesus is the King of Kings who humbled himself by coming to earth and dying on the cross. Jesus saves sinners like us so we can live for God's glory. Let's pray. God, we love you so much, and we come before you knowing, God, that we should give you all the glory and all the honor. And God, help us to realize that when we brag and when we boast about what we've done, God, that takes the glory away from you. God, help us to see that whenever we do things, it's not because we have awesome power, but God, because you have given us power to do those things in your holy name. God, we love you. We praise you, and we thank you for sending Jesus to die for us. And it's in his name we pray. Amen. At this time, you can work on the activity sheet. It would also be a good time to talk with your parents about what boasting really means. Have a great day, and we'll see you next week.